Welcome to Ace Design YouTube channels. From today we are going to start the CSS tutorials, the A to Z CSS tutorial series. We will announce this CSS tutorial from this today, and I will make this tutorial about the CSS, a lot of tutorials and a lot of things A to Z how much I know, and I will experiment that everything on into your eyes. And in this YouTube channel from today I'm going to start the CSS tutorial series. So CSS tutorial series, first of all we have to know that what is CSS. CSS means the cascade style sheet. So CSS is basically stand for the HTML element how to be displayed. So this CSS is that structure is that HTML element where to be displayed and how to be displayed and how we can display the HTML element. This is everything is depended by the CSS. The CSS, we will go to that this for the CSS. For today we are on the first day, we want to start that the CSS tutorial. And first day I just use that the topic is the CSS padding property. So let's jump to my VS code. So here is my VS code. You can see I have two files in this folder. You can see index.html and another one is style.css file. So I have there two folder and two files here. So I want to make this here, this two folder I want to create it here. Let's start the HTML file. So you have to type on the shift plus one and click on to enter. So here you can see that the basic HTML structure will be here. So we'll change the title name here, this CSS padding. We'll type here the CSS padding, and now I will connect here the style file. So I will type here the link and click on enter here and type here that style.css. And now I will go to this style.css file. So I will type here the basic CSS. So enter here. So I'm typing here the margin. Here is okay. So now type here the padding zero. I want to add here a font family. So font family sans serif. Okay, so here is the basic HTML and the basic CSS. So now we'll go to here the in HTML file here the body section, click on enter here. So I'm typing here a padding. So first of all we have to type here dot, and we are typing here the definition is class name. So I'm typing here the class name is padding. Because of we are typing here this, we are going to learn that the padding property. So I'm typing here simply padding, the class name you can type here anything. So then click on to enter here, and now I type some text here. So I'm typing here my channel name. Okay, that's it. So let's open this with the live server, and you can see here there is design, it's showing on this the left side and the top. So we want to make this text one here on the center. So let's copy this class name here, the padding, and enter that CSS file. So now I'm typing here the margin. So I want to take they make that text on the center. So vertically center here. I want to make here this 50 VS and auto. So the text will be vertically center, and let's check it. You can see that text is vertically here on this edge design here, and if we make that we can see it's showing here. So let's go to this here, this margin 50 VS and auto here. So I want to add here some width, I want to add width is 100 pixel, and height is add some height, and I want to add is height is 50 pixel. Okay, so now add a background. So I'm typing here the background. So background must be, I want to type a color is background zero, and typing a font color. So color is hashtag FFF. So it will be background will be black and the color will be white. So let's go to here, and you can see that text is on the here on this center, the vertically it's on center here. You can see, and this but this text is on this top. So we want to make this text on the center. So we'll type here text align center and align item center. Okay, Now let's check it. Must be the text will be center here. You can see the text is on the center. So this text is on the goat here. So we'll make this text on the center using the padding here. Okay. I should make that decrease some height here. So I'm typing here this 30 pixel and let's add the font size. So I'm typing here font size will should be, I'm typing as a 20 pixel. Now let's open it live server and you can see this text is gone this height. So we should make some more weight. I want to make this weight is increasing here. Okay, weight is 200 and you can see now it's looking good. And we can also decrease the height as 25 pixel. That must be the text will be on the center. Sorry, I have typed here this 250 pixel. So 25 pixel. You can see the text is vertically here, the center on this padding here. So now I will using here this padding or basic here this in this tutorial or basic point. And the main point is padding. So we are typing here the padding. So here is the padding property. For a padding property have this total four. Include this padding property have the top here this total four property. That is top. That is top and this. So I'm going to type here. I'm just going to show you that. The padding property have this four element into this, the top, bottom, left and right. So if we use here this first top, we use here this 10 pixel padding and this one, this only one, this 10 pixel one element into this padding property. So it will be this 10 pixel will be applicable for the top, bottom, left and right. Let's check it. You can see that 10 pixel the padding properties applied for this top, bottom, left and everything, for everything is here. Because of this here we have typed some height here. If we remove that height it will be show more that. So you can see it's applied and this for everything is working as well as. And you can see the padding property is 10 pixel. So if we add here another property, another element is I'm going to type here another element is 20 pixel. So now it will be work for this two property, padding property two element. This 10 pixel will work for this top and bottom. And this 20 pixel will work for left and right. Let's check it. You will be see here. You can see now this left and right is increased some more and more. So more side is increased here. So here's if we add another property. So I'm writing here this 10 pixel. And I'm typing 20 pixel. So now here this three, that four element is applied here. This 10 pixel will be work for the top. And this 20 pixel will be work for the right and this 10 pixel will be I want to make some increase, that's why you can understand add easily. I want to make this 15 pixel and here I want to add 25. So there is different type of pixel and element on this, the four element. This 10 pixel will work for top from the top and this 20 pixel element will be work for from the right side and this 15 pixel will be work from the left side. And this 25 pixel will be work from the bottom side, from the below side. So as we open this, the open with live server, you can see here we have added here this 25 pixel for this bottom. So you can see here some more space. For example, if we increase the bottom pixel here, then you will be able to see that perfectly. So you can see here this space is going some more around here. And this space and this all space is going some around into this. For example, if we enter here this the right side, I'm typing here 5500 pixel as just for example. You can see here this, I'm going to increase that skin. You can see here this is here the left is, we have type here on theirs. I'm going to show you that there's, you can see that for this left property have this. We can see here this left property is 50 pixel for this left, sorry, 50 pixel for this, 15 pixel for this left property here. And now as you see here this, we have added that right property will be 500. So you can see that 500% there is so much of increase of the weight here into here this created here. So now let's go to inside this here this 500 pixel here will increase decrease here this, I want to type here 100 pixel. So it will work for 100 pixel. And if we made here the stop changing, want to make the some more width here this from the top here, from the top side I want to make some more space. Let's go to that, and here I will type from this, this section is this element or for the top. So I want to type here this 200 pixel, and you can see this will be more space. You can see from the top side, you can see from the top side we have got more space, that is 200 pixel around to here. So let's go to here. So this is the padding property. Basically we use for this padding property the two element, that is we use maximum time 10 pixel and 20 pixel, like this two element we use for that. Because of that, this 10 pixel will be top, from this top and bottom will be 10 pixel and left and right will be 20 pixel. So this equally, the padding will be equally that. So then I want to show you that you can see the padding will be equal, top and bottom will be same and left and right will be same, and this text will be vertically on the center from the padding, inside the padding. So this is the padding property, how we can apply that this top, top, bottom, left, right. With this this four element of this padding property, we have that this total four element, top, bottom, right and left. So this is the padding property element here. So I have shown that this everything is understanding that analysis about that padding property. If you understand that everything, that padding property, our what is padding property, if you like that video, please like on this and share our these videos, and please subscribe our channels and press the bell icon for all notification and all updates. Thank you so much for watching this video, and goodbye.